गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, बैक टू आवर मैथमेटिक्स लेक्चर. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 3, एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इंटीजर्स. सो लेट्स लर्न वन बाय वन विद द बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस लेसन. एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड सम ज्योमेट्रिकल लेसन्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सम मैथमेटिकल एल्जेब्रिक लेसन्स. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट वी हैव लर्नड इन आवर प्रीवियस ईयर about natural numbers. Now, what is natural numbers? Natural numbers is a group of numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. All these set of numbers are called as either natural numbers or they are even called as counting numbers. The smallest natural number is 1. And these natural numbers are said to be positive numbers. The symbol of natural number is capital N. Again, the next that we have learned in our previous classes are whole numbers. Now, what is the difference between natural and whole number is, whole number has one more digit extra in it, that is 0. It's at the beginning. So, 0 is also considered as a number. So, hence when we get a set of numbers including 0 into that with natural numbers are called as whole numbers. Now here example is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So the smallest whole number is 0. Now the symbol of whole number is capital W. Coming to the next part. Now these natural numbers and whole numbers increase in the value. That means they are more than 1 back to 1. Back 1 back 1 again the numbers, the value of the number increases. From left to right. So here numbers are starting from 1 and it goes on. So greater than 1, the number which has more value than 1 is 2. The number which has more value than 2 is 3 and so on. From left, this side is a left, from left to right. Next, in whole numbers if I'll say, if it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now again here the same thing, the number which has more value than 0 is 1. Again from 1 which is more value is 2 and so on. So again here the value increases from left to right. Now the natural numbers and whole numbers are infinite. That means there is no end to it. There are n number of numbers which we cannot know which is the end of these kind of numbers. It's infinite. So we don't know which is the greatest number. One cannot find out which is the greatest number. We can only say which is the smallest one. Now, the next thing that we are going to learn is negative numbers. Now, the numbers which are less than 0, as we have already learned that natural numbers are called as positive numbers. So, what is negative numbers? The negative numbers are the numbers which are less than 0. Now, you may think we have not learned any number which is less than 0. But yes, children, we have numbers which is less than 0 and these numbers are called as negative numbers. Now, negative numbers are, for example, minus 1, minus 2, minus 10, minus, you know, these kind of numbers which has a sign minus to the left of it. Now, these positive numbers, 0 and negative numbers, together form a group of numbers called as integers. Now, as we have learned, natural numbers symbol is N, whole numbers symbol is W. Similarly, integers have also symbol called as Z, capital Z. An example of integers, again as I said it is positive 0 and negative. Some examples are minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on both the sides, on the left and right it's infinite. Now here minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 are negative numbers. 0 is the origin which is neither positive nor negative and 1, 2, 3, 4 are positive numbers that we have learned in natural numbers. Now integer family. Now guess children, you all are living with your family members, right? Now if I take a family of mother, father and a child, a family having only mother, father and a child, it's a neutral family, the smallest family. If I will include your grandparents in it, only your grandparents with your father, mother and you, it's a family which is more big than your neutral family. But if I include the entire family, group of family members having relatives, uncle, auntie, brother, sister, niece, nephew and all with your grandparents, you and your parents. It's a kind of joint family. Similarly, here in integer family also, the same set moves on. The smallest part of integer family, which is a part of integer, is natural numbers. Again, when I extend it with zero whole numbers, again, this is a big set of numbers greater than natural numbers. Now, when I include both whole and natural with the negative numbers, the entire family is called as an integer family. Now, children, suppose you go to a mall. Okay, when you go to a mall, you can see in the lift there is a button kept below zero and above zero. Now, above zero, you know the lift is moving upwards. It's increasing. Stepwise, it is increasing up and up. But when you press a number below zero, that means you're going underground. You're going below that area. Hence, it is written as minus. So, same case comes up with our integer also when we learn integer through a number line. Now, see here, I have a number line which has a number 0 in the middle, which is neither positive nor negative. On the right side, there are positive numbers. On the left, there are negative numbers. Same numbers, but only the difference is the sign for it. So, when points on a line represent numbers, these numbers on that line are called as, and these line is called as number line. The number becomes bigger as we move towards right. It becomes smaller as we move towards left. Always keep in mind the positive numbers are greater than the negative numbers. Numbers which become smaller, it will become smaller and smaller from the left side, towards the left side, I could say. Of any two numbers on the number line, take any two numbers. For example, I am taking minus 1 and plus 1, that is 1 over here. Always the number to the left, that is over here, minus 1 is smaller. Or you take, suppose, minus 3 and 1. Still, minus 3 is the smaller. Keep in mind, any number of the number line towards the left is always smaller than the number on the right side. Even if I'm taking minus 4 and 0, which is smaller, minus 4 is smaller. As per the rule, any number on the left side is smaller. Now, coming to the next part, negative and positive numbers. How to read negative and positive numbers? Negative numbers, as we saw, minus 3, minus 2 and all, how can we read it? We read it as negative 3, negative 4, negative 12, negative 24 and so on. When I come to positive number, I read it as positive 8, positive 25, positive 2, positive 50 and so on. How do we write it now? How do we write negative and positive numbers using symbols? Positive numbers are written as plus 1, plus 6, plus 5, plus 10, plus 15 and so on. Negative numbers are written as minus, that is negative 3, minus 3, minus 8, or I could say minus 100 or negative 54 and so on. So if a number is written without a sign, suppose you get a question where in front of number, even in the number line we saw, numbers on the right side after 0, there were no symbols given to it. Just 1, 2, 3, 4 was written. Now these numbers which are with or without symbol is to be taken as a positive number. For example, here I have plus 7. We can write plus 7 as 7 as well, because positive, there is no rule in positive numbers that you need to write or put a symbol to it. It's understood that it is positive. Now, these are the basics that we have learned in this lesson, the first part of the lesson, which has some group of numbers like natural, whole and integers, a number line in it. And we learned about positive, negative numbers, how to distinguish it, how to write the symbols for it. Now, based on all these basics of the lesson, we are having some assignments. Also, we are solving the exercise based on this. Let's see it two one by one. Now, write the following numbers in symbols. Positive 14 is written as plus 14, that is plus sign and 14, or you can just write 14. Negative 7 is written as minus 7 using the symbol minus. Positive 23 is written as plus 23. Negative 9 is written as minus 9. Positive 5 is written as plus 5. Now, positive 82 is written as plus 82. Coming to the next assignment of the same basics. Read the following numbers and write them in words. minus 5 is written as negative 5 in words. Even we read it as negative, but for saying, for asking the question, I am just using the symbols to understand how to write it. Plus 3, that is positive 3, is written in words. Next, minus 1 is written as negative 1. Plus 7 is written as positive 7. Minus 2 is written as negative 2. And plus 15 is written as positive 15. Exercise from the textbook, that is problem set 4. Classify the following numbers as positive numbers and negative numbers. So here we can see some group of numbers having plus and minus sign in each. So we have to make a table, write positive and negative on it. On each side we have to find out which has minus sign comes under negative, which has plus sign comes under positive. So here we have numbers like minus 5, plus 4, minus 2, 7, plus 26, minus 49, minus 37, 19, minus 25, plus 8, 5, minus 4, minus 12, 27. So here you could see some numbers are having the plus sign in it and some numbers are without sign. As we have learned before as well, the numbers that do not have sign are also called as positive numbers. So let's see the answer. Positive numbers from the group of numbers given are plus 4, 7, 26, 19, plus 8, 5, 27. In negative numbers, it is minus 5, minus 2, minus 49, or negative 37, negative 25, negative 4, and negative 12. Next question from the exercise given below are the temperature in some cities. As you see these cities with some temperatures given here, let's take an example now. You're staying in Maharashtra, the climate is hot and humid kind now, being rainy season. But do you feel the kind of chill cold or something? No, because as we are experiencing heat as well. But when I talk about Jammu Kashmir and all, when you stay there, will you feel this heat over there? No, there the temperature is low. So when the temperature is low, it is minus. When the temperature is high, it is plus. Now, how to distinguish low and high? If the temperature comes below 0 degree, that is below 0, as in number line also, below 0 it is minus. Above 0 it is plus. Similarly, here also, if the numbers are written as below 0, it is minus, that is negative. If the numbers are written above 0, it is positive. So, coming here, Shimla, 7 degree Celsius below 0 degree. So, you can find out, below 0 degree means negative. Again, Leh is 12 degree Celsius below 0 degree. Again, below 0 degree means negative. So, let's see the answer. Now, Shimla, the temperature is 7 degree Celsius below 0 degree. As I said, in number line also we've learned, below 0 degree means minus, that is negative 7 degree Celsius. Leh, 12 degree Celsius below 0 degree, that is negative 12 degree Celsius. We can also say as minus 12 degree Celsius in our normal language. Delhi, 22 degree Celsius above 0 degree, that is positive. So 22 degree Celsius we can write, or we can write with symbol, that is plus 22 degree Celsius. We can write either of the answers. Nagpur, 31 degree Celsius above 0 degree. We can write it as 31 degree Celsius directly, or positive 31 degree Celsius. Coming to the last question of your exercise, write the numbers in the following examples using the proper signs. A submarine is at a depth of 512 meters below the sea level. Is at a depth of below the sea level. Now, just assume sea level is zero. Okay, from a number line, if I compare number line and sea level, zero, think it as zero is our sea level. Okay, so anything below the sea level is negative. Anything above the sea level is positive. Now, our sky is above the sea level. So, we can take it as positive. When I come to the sea bed, that is below sea, it comes under negative. So, here a submarine is at a depth, that is below sea level of 512 meters. So, when it is below, you can understand that it is negative. So, the answer is minus 512 meters. The height of Mount Everest, that means top. Already height means we are speaking about the tip of the point, this particular anything or person. So here we are taking the height of Mount Everest. Its highest peak in Himalayas is 848 meters. So as we are speaking about height, It is positive. So we can write it with symbol or without symbol. 8848, that is 8848 meters, or we could write it as positive 8848 meters. A kite is flying at a distance of 120 meters from the ground. Now a kite is flying at a distance of 120 meters from the ground. That means above the ground it is, from the ground. We are standing on the ground and we are flying the kite towards the sky. So it is above the ground. Assume ground as 0 degree or 0 from the number line, and think it is, the kite is flying above the ground. From the ground, so 120 meters above us. So it is positive. The tunnel is at a depth of 2 meters under the ground. As I said you, ground is 0. From the ground or above the ground is positive. Under the ground is negative. When it comes to depth or under the ground, it is negative. So answer is negative 2 meters. So we have done with the lesson, first part of the lesson. Thank you students to patiently listen to it. You can solve all these kinds of questions in your book. Even write those points, those definitions of negative, positive and all these numbers as pointers in your maths notebook.